We had the biggest move yet was in the CAD, dollar CAD, the pound CAD, and now the euro CAD, and you can see them. You can see the big move in the CAD from last week. We had the structure long last week. If you look at the, this is again, these are the nice setup trades, guys, that you want to be looking at. We had a structure, a long point, which is the 136, 23, right there. Once we traded above it and we failed, it became a sell signal. And if you would have shorted it anywhere around here, you would have had a couple of hundred pips. Once you have a signal that fails, that's how we get paid on the failure trade. And then it got you black down below the 136.34. So if you missed it the first time, you could have taken it the second time. And looking at, that is your 136. The 136.23. This is what we highlighted for you last week. And once it failed, look at this. Somewhere over here, that would have been a sell signal on the 16th, and that would have been a lovely trade. The one thing that I have reservation about this trade is that all the pairs versus the Canadian closed at pretty much the dead low. All of them were big ranges. All of them, I need to have confirmation that this thing is going to continue further before I actually pull the trigger. I'm going short. Yes, the trend is to the downside. I have no issue with that, and I'm still looking for a short selling, but I have, again, this is one of our the 134.63, and we close the week at 134.82, so we're just 20 pips away from our entry. So I will short the EuroCAD below 134.63.7. My structure for short here is still 134.63, and in this case my stop is going to be the 134.63.7. So my short point is my structure short, and it is my stop. On the buy side, if I have to look at this chart, I really have no reason. There's nothing here that shows me where I don't have an entry, a technical entry to buy it. So I'm going to look at the daily to try to pinpoint the price point where I can buy. No, it's just there's nothing. 138, 134.80. I'll probably take this low, 135. The reason I'm taking this low, again, we do things in a consistent way. It is not, the reason I'm taking that is the rule of price behavior. I want to see how a price point behaves, so I can use it as a buy or a sell signal. So here, the 135, when it broke below it and it came back above it and tested, we really had a good range day. So I didn't choose any of those. This one, because that's the reaction that has followed after. And if that's the behavior, that's what I'm looking for, so at least I can put the odds on my side. Okay? So in this case, I'm going to be buying it above the 135.28. Okay, and if that's the case, my structure now is still the 136, 136.341, and if I buy it above 135.22, I'm going to place my stop below the low of the day, which is the 134.83. I'm putting my buy point on the chart so that if it does trade above it while we're trading, I'm going to take it from there. There is my buying point. So we're going to buy above here. Okay, and my stop is below the lows, and my structure is right there. Okay, that is the EuroCAD. If anybody has any questions, feel free.